Hello friends, welcome to NIOS Studio. Today I'm going to speak about role of school and teachers in developing thinking skills. I am Divya Sharma from University of Delhi. Let's talk about thinking skills and what do they mean. Okay, so the mental processes that we apply to make sense of our everyday experience is what do we call as thinking skills. So it will include all those basic skills we use for our for remembering, questioning, forming the concepts, planning, reasoning, imagining, problem solving, decision making, translating thoughts into words, and so on. So these kind of skills which we apply in our everyday life for making sense of everyday world and in the kind of experiences we gain throughout, that include all those thinking skills. Improving thinking skills is important because it leads to intellectual or mental development of our students. So that's important for us to help in improving these thinking skills among the learners. Then understanding of students and curricular devices are very important for developing thinking skills. So as an educator, it's required that we should have an understanding of our students. We should understand their needs, their abilities, and their environment, their background, everything which is required to channelize their thinking processes, and various curricular devices that are being engaged in the school, okay, in their learning. So the whole thing is like targeting or channelized for developing thinking skills among learners. We also need to provide stimulating environment in schools to engage learners actively in thinking. So whichever way our classrooms are made or they are programmed, they should be giving the kind of stimulating environment, the positive feedback and reinforcement to our learners so that they can actively engage in thinking processes and do regular practice of their thinking skills. There are certain ways or certain devices in through our curriculum where we can actually do interventions for improving thinking abilities among our learners. It will include objective of teaching and instruction that we know that they are always set for any course, for any subject which we teach in our schools. So those objectives of teaching and instruction can be leading to us to the development of thinking skills. Then curriculum development can be done taking into consideration of this requirement of improving thinking abilities among children. Designing of textbooks and other instructional material, the teaching aids we use in general, and various materials to support their learning, they should also be planned and organized in certain ways. They can be developed in certain ways where the thinking abilities of children can be improved by their use. Then our methods and techniques of teaching, whichever way we are implementing our teaching techniques, they can also be done in certain ways where their thinking abilities are given a regular practice in classrooms. Then different models of teachings are also existing. So it's up to us whichever model of teaching we are adopting in our classrooms, and it's important that we always see that each model of thinking has some underlying thinking abilities, and those should be explicitly used when you are using them. Evaluation and diagnosis processes can also be done or can also be organized in certain ways where thinking skills are mainly emphasized. Remedial teaching and instructions are also done in schools, and there again we can emphasize development of thinking skills of children. So the question is, how to stimulate thinking skills then? Are there any strategies which a teacher can use to stimulate thinking skills among children? Yes, teachers can do a lot if they are actually aware of the need to make children use and practice these thinking skills in variety of ways. Like, we can use a lot of teaching strategies that would foster both the development of thinking skills and at the same time mastery of subject matter. what happens, like generally when we are in classroom and teaching some subject, our major focus goes on teaching of the contained matter, the subject matter, and somehow the way thinking and reasoning has to be applied to arrive at those concepts, those those principles in your subject matter, they may be not underlined so much. So it's important that as teacher we need to use our strategy in those ways where we can foster the development of thinking skills also, that kind of reasoning and the way we can analyze information, interpreting, drawing conclusions. Okay, so all those thinking skills can be developed along with the subject matter. So there is nothing like only if you are focusing one aspect, then other thing can be ignored. Similarly, next strategy which you can apply is when your learners succeed at any task of any kind, you can actually focus their attention on and label the skill, the thinking skill which they have used. Okay, so you can actually ask them to think aloud which skill they have applied, how they have reasoned about the given situation. Okay, so here actually it's to underline what thinking skills they have used and let them identify it. Then you can also be acting as a role model, because if you are able to model strategies by thinking aloud in your classroom, or when you yourself employ any thinking skill successfully in classroom, you can ask your student that, okay, what was the thinking skill behind the strategy you have used? So your student should be observing you. Okay, so you can give them that opportunity by asking them why you did something and what was the thinking skill which was leading to that particular conclusion. Okay, so in that way you will be modeling those strategies in front of your students. Also you can encourage your students to reflect on what have they done. Okay, whenever they have applied any kind of thinking strategy, whether problem solving or decision making or analyzing situations, so if you have seen that they have done this very effectively and successfully, so you would also be giving them some encouragement and motivation to do this regularly, and also help them to reflect. You have to encourage them to see what has been done and how it has been done so effectively. So their reflection is very important at those points. You also encourage your students to talk to themselves while they think. You must have seen children talking to themselves when they are actually so deeply involved in a given task. So talking to themselves is not something which is alien to them. They do talk. Okay, but maybe in the beginning years, in the early years, you can allow them to think and talk aloud to themselves. It's like giving themselves a feedback what they have done. Okay, but later on, just encourage them to think silently in their mind. It's always helpful to give them a track, to give them a direction in which they have to proceed. So thinking and talking to themselves is another way of encouraging children to become more and more better in their thinking abilities. You should also help students learn basic skills of task, because in any given task you require certain basic skills to become more of automaticity should be there. By practicing those basic skills, it becomes like children they spare their extra energy or their more time mainly on their thinking part. Okay, so you can help them to learn certain skills of task which they have repeatedly used to become more of autonomous on those tasks. So rather than spending their energies on just calculating something, for example, I'm taking from maths, you are giving them some equation, so if they know the process, if they know the algorithm, they will be able to solve it. And then later you can ask them to focus on their thinking, how they actually arrived at the solution. Also it would be required if you can emphasize not just on the knowledge of strategies. Okay, so there are strategies available to find out solution of a problem, but it's not just their strategies are important to be known, rather than their values and how they have to be used is more important. Okay, so you must emphasize that children should be able to underline and they should be able to recognize the value of thinking skills and the strategies they have used in certain situations. And similarly, at the same time, you must be helping your students realize the conditional nature of thinking skills. Okay, there are certain situations where you can apply problem solving, where you can actually analyze things given to you. So the point is, you must be able to realize the conditional nature of thinking skill, in the sense that when to use them is important, not just how to use. So one is, you have made them to recognize, okay, how to use these skills, how to arrive at conclusion, how to analyze given facts, but also when these skills have to be used, the situations are to be recognized well as such. Similarly, it is advisable that as a teacher, you can also help in transfer of strategies learned in a particular setting. So in the original setting, they have learned how to apply those strategies, but yes, automatically children won't be able to transfer them in variety of settings. Okay, so you need to be aware of their need, the kind of support you would be giving them, so that they are successfully able to transfer the learned strategies beyond the original strategies. Next would be, like, you should emphasize certain connections and integration of knowledge acquired on different occasions. Like we were talking about transfer of strategies, transfer of learning made in some setting to the new setting. So here, what do we need to basically emphasize? Some connections or some similar elements which they need to be focused about. And if they are able to recognize those common elements and features, so they would be better able to integrate knowledge acquired on different occasions. So it will help them to channelize their thinking in more streamlined ways. Should also provide feedback on the degree to which learners have evaluated their comprehension correctly, not just on the degree to which they have comprehended. So here you need to understand that feedback is also very important for your learners. Next is, you need to be careful that, attention to thinking skills does not detract them so much from learning by competing for limited learning resources. What I mean here is that, you need to be careful that whatever they have applied, okay, whatever the thinking skills they are applying in the situation given, it should not detract them from learning by competing for the limited learning resources, which are otherwise need to be devoted to all other academic purposes as well. Then you should also encourage your students to work together on higher order activities. Okay, so it means it's important for you to arrange some peer group learning, or collaborative learning activities, where they would learn, they would work together in smaller group, and they can be actually modeling their thinking skills to in front of each other. So it will help them to self-evaluate their effectiveness of their thinking skills or thinking strategies in a comparative mode. So when they are working in a peer group, it's very important for them to pull together their ideas, to think together, and also to display their thinking skills effectively to each other. And this is how they would be able to think more about how they have applied their thinking strategies for arriving at certain conclusions. So group activities are also one way where you can encourage your students to use higher order thinking skills. Then some classroom techniques which you can always use as a teacher to inculcate thinking strategies or thinking skills among your students. For example, I would take a few examples, like you can use brainstorming technique. In other sessions, we have already talked about brainstorming. Here I am just summarizing that, okay, if you are starting from brainstorming on certain idea, like you are taking some concept and you are starting your class for teaching the concept of tree maybe. Okay, so you just ask your students how trees are important for us, or whatever they know about tree, they will just come out with number of ideas. So it's more of like thinking in divergent ways about a given concept or a given topic, and number of ideas would be generated. So here you have actually stimulated your students to think in various multiple dimensions about the topic in hand. Then strategies like odd one out. Generally, we give them some exercises where they actually need to pick up one odd one situation out of the given lot. Okay, so there again, if these situations, if these kind of questions and exercises are given to them, so children would be needed to pick up the odd one out by applying some thinking, some logical reasoning. Okay, so it means this kind of strategy will also help you to promote thinking and reasoning among children. Journal writing is another common exercise you can do with your students, where you can ask them to maintain a journal, or where whatever ideas are coming up to them on any given occasion, they can just write it down. So it may be daily journal writing, okay, where you can ask them to pick up just one instance of their daily routine and then think about it and write explicitly about it in any way, okay, not even caring for whether it is right or wrong, but just the way they want. So whatever idea is coming to them, you know, regarding a topic, they are free to write. So this way again, you can help them in thinking about a particular topic in a free way. KWL is another strategy which sometimes can be used by teachers, and it's mainly, it can be expanded, where K is is mainly about what I know already when I come to class. Okay, W is what I want to know as learner, and learned means what I have learned after the class is over. I have one example for you to share about KWL. For example, if I am using KWL strategy in my classroom, and supposedly I am teaching graphs, okay. So, I am putting this chart in my classroom and I start with what children actually know about pie graphs, okay. So, children may come up with certain responses like, okay, they know a bit about that it's a graph and graphs record data and pie graph looks like a circle, okay. So, these are certain prior ideas which are already held by children. So, then next thing what can we ask through what I want to know category. So, here children can put up certain queries or certain curiosities in ways of questions like what kind of data can you record in a pie graph. So, it may be a query coming from the side of children, so that they actually want to know through your class. And next question, like, are they called pie graphs because they look like pie? So, these are very simple queries coming from children's side, but yes, it shows that they actually want to know something. And then after you have discussed, after you have used some techniques to sort out and to satiate their curiosities, then at the end of your lesson, maybe you can ask children to sum up what they have learnt, whether their queries have been addressed or not. So, they may come up like, okay, you can't record all types of data on a pie graph. It means they have specificity of the data, okay. They are called pie graphs because they don't look like pie. So, you can see a continuity. This is just a simple example I have taken from a blog, okay. But yes, for any subject, you can use KWL strategy, where your students will be able to track what they were knowing, what they want to know, and what they have learned out of the class. So, somehow they have, they get a chance to track their thinking, and their understanding has grown to which particular direction. Questioning is another important technique which you can use to foster thinking among children. So, yes, if they question, it means they are obviously thinking about what is going on in classroom. Okay, so they simply don't receive everything on the face value. So, if they are questioning, it means they are curious to know about things. So, you have to support, you have to encourage questioning, and you also need to question in certain ways which help them, which trigger on thinking among them. So, questioning by teacher, by student, both are important, and in a classroom where questioning is a regular feature, you know that thinking is always fostered. Then you provide with verbal tools which are necessary for analysis of internalized mental processes. So, children should be able to verbalize, okay, whatever is going on in their minds. So, if you are giving them some situation to think about, to logically analyze certain situations, so anything can be given, and then you just ask them, okay, how they have arrived at a particular solution or conclusion. So, if they are having a good vocabulary, or they are able to verbalize what they have thought, it's always important, okay, that will be making it visible or observable for you also Okay, so what they have actually thought about and how it has been done. Mind mapping or concept mapping is another commonly used method by which you can actually make their thinking visible. So in the same way that brainstorming works, here also you can give them a concept, and then it's not just random choice of ideas, randomly put up ideas, rather. Okay, so in a way it can give a visual image of how children actually relate various concepts with its sub-concepts. So when you develop a kind of concept map in your classroom with the help of children coming out with different ideas, and it is expanded side by side. Okay, you can start with, okay, what is tree? How do you know, what do you know about trees? So children may come up, okay, tree provide oxygen, they provide shade, they provide shelter, they provide papers, okay, they provide food. It can be, you know, expanded in number of direction based on their responses. Okay. Similarly, that again can be expanded. Some children may also come up with the idea, okay, it is required for all living organism, oxygen is required. So how it can be connected? So then oxygen and organisms can be connected by another way of connector. So similarly, your own classroom, your own subjects may have number of kind of concept maps based on how the classroom discussion progresses. Then there is a concept of brain gym kind of activities. Certainly these are some kind of exercises or mental exercises which are having the purpose to encourage students to think in a diversity of ways. So these are kind of exercises only which develop or which tune up your mental faculties to think in certain ways. Then concept of thinking hats is also applicable in certain situations, where if you remember in certain session we talked about six thinking hats, okay, and each color of hat, white, blue, red, black, red, yellow, okay, they all had different colors, and each color symbolized a different kind of thinking focus. Okay, so there, this strategy, if used in classroom, its idea is to mainly challenge different directions of brain in which we want our learners to focus at a particular time. So if we want our children to focus only on the factual details of a data or a situation, so what we would do, like we would be hinting them, we would be selecting the white hat in that way. Okay, so thinking hat concept can also be applied basically in certain situations where you want them to practice on one particular direction in which brain can think upon. There are certain computers and educational softwares available which maybe in absence of teacher, they can also regulate or modulate children in certain ways, and they can actually direct how to go about in solving a situation or a problem, and children can put on their thinking processes to go in a certain direction. Okay, so these are some common strategies which can be applied by you as teacher, and then it is important that you should be able to realize that thinking skills are very, very important to be developed among learners. We have already talked about why thinking skills are important and how different strategies can be applied by teachers to develop these thinking skills among students. And we know that if we are teaching a subject, it's not just our focus should be only on content, okay, rather than when our focus should be to nurture these thinking skills among students, these thinking processes which will help them to self monitor their thoughts, to become more and more critical, and make them progress towards self learning in longer term. So these thinking skills are not just required for classroom situations, you are inculcating them to enable for a better prospect, so that they can be they can advance as a thinker, as a critical thinker, and they can use these thinking skills in their everyday situations. So let's wind up our session here only, and I hope you have got a basic understanding about your role as a teacher in developing thinking skills among your learners. So let's meet in another session. Thank you very much.